In this video, we're going to start the KutaSoftware Infinite Algebra 1 free worksheet visualizing data. Now in this video, I'm going to go over numbers 1 and 2, in which we're going to draw a dot plot for each data set. So for the data set in number 1, we're looking at hits in a round of hacky sack. Now when drawing a dot plot, we want to start with a line that's like a number line. Now for our range of that line, we need to start by figuring out our starting number and our ending number. So in number 1, our numbers are actually in order from least to greatest, going left to right. So starting with 2, 2 will be our smallest number, and 13 will be our largest number. So our first tick mark will represent 2, and then we'll have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and then 13. So what I did, I just counted by 2s. 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. But each tick mark represents one value. So 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. Now, above those tick marks, we're going to mark with a dot how many times that number occurs. So number 2 occurs once. So I'm going to draw a dot above 2. Now, looking at the next value, number 3 occurs once. So I'm going to draw a dot above number 3, keeping it in line with the same dot I drew from number 2. So essentially, these first dots represent that there's 1, 2, and 1, 3. And there's also 1, 4. So we're going to draw one dot above 4. Now for 5, there's 1, 2, 3, 4 fives that occur in our data, so we're going to draw 4 fives. So we're going to draw 4 dots above our 5 tick mark. So 1, 2, 3, and then 4, keeping them evenly spaced, where that first dot is in line with all the other dots that represent 1. Now moving on to 6, we have 2 sixes, so we're going to draw 2 dots. So note that the second dot stays in line with the second dot that was above the 5. For 7, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 sevens, so that's going to be 4 dots, which is the same as 5, so we're going to keep those in line. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and then there's 1, 8, and 1, 13. So drawing 1 dot above the 8, 0 above 9, 0 above 10, 0 above 11, 0 above 12, and then 1 above 13. And that's our dot plot in number 1. And dot plots are very useful for looking at our data visually. You can see that 5 hits and 7 hits are the most popular in a round of hacky sack, whereas 13 is a bit of an outlier because there's a huge gap between the next closest value. So those are just some things that you can see in a dot plot. Let's move on to number 2. Number 2, we're looking at hours slept. So let's start by drawing our horizontal line. Now, unlike our data in number 1, this data is not in order, so I'm going to go through finding the smallest number. In the first row, 4 is our smallest number. In the second row, there's nothing smaller than 4. Therefore, 4 is going to be our first tick mark. Now let's look for that greatest value. Looking in the first row, 9 is our greatest value, and in our second row of data, there is no number greater than 9, so 9 will be our last tick mark on our dot plot. So we'll need to fill in 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I'll just count by 1s. 5, 6, 7, and 8. Now let's go through our data, marking our dots. So 7, we'll put a dot on 7, then we'll put a dot on 4, then we'll put a dot on 6, keeping those first dots in line, then we'll put another dot on 7, so 7 now has 2 dots. Now here comes our dot on 9, 7 will get a third dot, 6 will get its second dot. making sure I'm keeping those dots in line. Next, 7 will get another dot. So 7 is up to 4 dots now because it's occurred 4 times so far. Then 6 will get another dot. And then 8. So 8 finally has its first dot. And then 7 will get 2 more dots. Then 6 will get a dot. 7 will get 1 more dot. 6 will get 1 final dot. And then 5 will get its first dot. And that's our dot plot for the number of hours slept in number 2. And you can see visually that 6 and 7 are the hours that occur the most for hours slept, whereas 4, 5, and 8, and 9 only had 1 for that amount of hours. However, 6 had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sleep 6 hours, and 7 was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That was 2 more than 6 hours. So those are just a few pieces of information that you can gather visually from the dot plot in number 2. And I'll go ahead and stop this video here because in the next video we're going to be moving on to our next type of graphing, which are stem and leaf plots. However, before you continue on to that, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, and share this with your peers.